Hello guys and welcome to this video. And in this video we will be seeing about accessing data from the database and showing it on the web using Flask SQL Alchemy. So before we start, I would like to show basics of Flask ORM, that is the object related mapping which the Flask SQL Alchemy uses only for SQLite3 database. So what we'll do now is we go to the directory that we are working in and run a command called flask shell. So flask is basically a command which comes inbuilt. So I'm going to run flask shell, which will start up a shell, an interactive shell. You can also use Python to start that shell by just typing Python or Python 3 if you are in a another device. So what this flask shell is, it opens interactive shell and you can basically try out some code and do some small testing with the database, and also you can do some basic testing with that. So basically I'm going to show you how we can read values from database using the SQL Alchemy ORM and also filter data, that is querying. So what we'll do is we'll import the users class from the app itself. So we'll import users. So basically I've imported it. Now we can see users.query.all. So if you want to do any querying, like if you want to read the data from the database, you have to use the query method, and inside this query method you have other helpful methods which will help you to query data. So the first method is .all, query.all. basically it's users. Okay, it gives all the data in a form of an array. So inside the array you will have the user classes, the two user data, and you can basically access all the attributes of that class. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a variable called users, and I'm going to set it to users.query.all. basically I'm creating a variable to store all the value in the database, the users table of the database. So I'm going to press enter, and it's users, and you can see that it has been created. Now what I can do is I'll scroll a little bit down to clear my screen. Okay, so what we'll do is you can see user, and you can see that users, and you can see that we have the array as usual. Now what we can do is I will set user to users 0. So basically I'm taking the user 1 here, the first element of the array. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to type user. You can see that it comes as an independent thing instead of coming in an array. So what I'll do is we'll see user dot, and we can access all the attributes that we have given here, that is the ID, username, email and about user. So if I say dot, so ID, you can see that I get the ID. If I say email, I'll get the email. If I say the username, I will get the username. And if I say the about underscore user, then we'll get the about underscore user. Basically I'm getting the first thing that's in the table, so basically it's this one, and you can also recheck it, and it's the same thing that has been shown over here. So now I think you have understood the basics of reading all of the data. Now what we'll do is filtering. So we can use the query method to do filtering by saying dot filter by, and you have to give a parameter or a query. So the query, basically you have to give it in attribute. So you have to say like username equals Harish, and you can give multiple based on multiple things also. You can do like email equals my email basically, or you can say test address, like that. You can do for even multiple attributes. For now, for simplicity, I'm just taking username equals Harish because it is already over here. And after you have done this, you have to specify how much data you want. So either you want all the data that's given by the filter, or you want the first result by the filter, or you want only one result for the filter. Over here, the dot one works only if there is one record with the username Harish. If there are multiple records with the username Harish, then this code will fail and it will give us an error. So now I'm going to execute this, and you can see that it has executed successfully. But I'm going to execute this again. But what I'm going to do is create a new record again with the name of Harish over here also, and I'm going to put some gibberish over here, and I'm going to write all the changes. Now what will happen is, if I go again and run this, you can see that I get an error and it says that multiple rows were found with the exact same query that was given. So dot one works if there is only one the value in that record. So I think you understood that, and now we'll go to dot first. So dot first basically gives the first result that it gets from the table. So enter, you can see that I get the user one, and now to say that this is the first one, I'm going to basically store it in a variable again. I'm going to say user equals user dot query dot filter by dot first. I'm going to see user dot about user because our about user is different. And see that the user is not this and it is this because we are using the first method to get only the first record which is given by the filter. I hope you have understood the basics of filtering and querying. Now we will be seeing how to show the data on the web. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to exit this prompt, and I'm going to basically run this app.py over here. So let this run, and before that, after that, what we'll do is for opening the app, we will say app.route. We basically create a new route over here, and this will be slash show data. So basically we're going to show all data here, and we're going to name it the same, and we're going to return a render template. That is the show data dot html. So what, I'm not created this template yet, and I'll be creating now, and also the server is ready, and I will drag a new window over here, and I'll run localhost 5000, and you can see that what we have in our previous tutorial, we have it over here. Now what I'll do is I'll create a new template, and I will create it as show data dot html, and you see that what I'm going to do is just going to copy this. I'm not going to rewrite the code again to save time, and it's basically the same code, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove this, and I'm going to use Jinja to show what is over here on the back end on the html front end. So how we'll do that is, first we'll create a variable called user equals users dot query dot all. So I'm going to say this as all users like this, and what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a Jinja variable. If you don't know what's Jinja variable, please refer my previous tutorials. I put a link of my playlist in the description, and you can go through that tutorial, and it will tell you about Jinja variables and Jinja templating in Flask. So I'm going to create a variable called users, and it's a Jinja variable. I'm going to create all users. I'm going to assign it to the all users. So what we are going to do in the front end is, what we're going to do is, basically we're going to create a Jinja for loop. So Jinja for loop actually works like this. First you have to have a curly braces with the percentage sign syntax, Jinja syntax, and then you have to say for user in users. So basically user is our variable that we'll be using each iteration, and users is the variable that is coming from the backend. So after you have done this, it is compulsory to mention end for, or it will return us an error. And after that, I can give h1 over here, and I can, what I can do is I can, using the variable like this, using the double curly brackets, I can say user dot username. Basically what I'm doing is, the whole class over here has come here in the Jinja, and we are iterating through every record that is coming through the for loop, and basically we are printing the attribute like we have done it on the shell here. I'll just save this, and we'll go back over here, and we'll go to the route. See that whatever I had in my database has come here. You can see that. Now I'm going to delete this Harish over here. I'm going to delete it, I'm going to write it, and you can, if I reload, you can see that immediately gets updated when it reloads. And you can see that we have finally accessed the data. Now we can also use additional like this user dot email. So I'm just adding some additional data, and I can put the H4 tag over here, and I can say, let's say user dot about user. So I'll save this and go back over here. See that we get the user as usual, and also the email and the about user as we have mentioned over here in the Jinja template. And you can see that it's really helpful and makes it really easy to, you know, get the data from backend to the front end, and there is nothing complex here, and it's really easy. I hope you like my video. There's a red color subscribe button down. Just click it. It's for free. Don't worry. It just helps me to support this content. And do click on the like button and the notification bell so that you get notified when I post a new video. And I'll see you next time.